Is it clear what the difference between common mode and differential mode emission is? Okay, then let's focus a little bit more on that. Let's suppose we have this printed circuit board, and there are two connectors, one on the right and one on the left-hand side. And both connectors have cables. So for example, here we have the 12-volt connection, so 12-volt and ground. And also here we have 24-volt and ground. So let's suppose this is the circuit of a buck converter. You're inserting 12-volt here. Boost converter, thank you very much for. So we are inserting 12-volt here, and we are coming out with 24-volt at this side. So therefore, we need some components like a power switch, a controller IC, an energy storage element, a filtering capacitor, or whatever. As I mentioned, when we are turning on the circuitry, there is switching activity. There is DI over DD, DU over DD. But let's stay with DI over DD. So there is a current that is changing. The current is flowing in a loop. And it can also happen that parts of the current are flowing then on the ground plane. So this is my printed circuit board. And one layer of this printed circuit board is acting as a ground plane. To be honest, we should not call this thing ground plane. It should be a signal return plane. Because we get the impression that, this is a ground plane, so ground is zero potential all over. There is all over zero potential. And there is no current flowing because it's zero potential or something. This is not the case in reality. So the ground plane is actually just a kind of signal return plane. So the current is mainly flowing out of the IC at the top layer on a printed circuit board trace that we are drawing on the printed circuit board design tool. And then the current flows somewhere into another IC. But the current has to flow back to this IC where it's coming from. And sometimes the current flows back via the ground plane. So therefore, it's a signal return plane. And now we have the problem. This is then the way how we are generating this differential mode and common mode currents, or the common mode emission. For the differential mode emission, I think it's pretty simple. The current, as I mentioned, is flowing in a loop. And then out of the loop, we are generating some electromagnetic energy, magnetic fields coming out of there. OK, this is then the reason for differential mode emission. For common mode emission, I said that also a part of the current is flowing along the ground plane, along the signal return plane. So what is the signal return plane made of in a printed circuit board? Copper. Okay. What's the specific resistance of copper? Not zero ohm. I think it's clear. So there is also an ohmic resistance along this path where the current is flowing. Okay. So how big is the resistance? Very, very small, 0-point-something ohm. So there is not that much voltage drop when the current is flowing. I think it is clear. But now, let's imagine the current, as I mentioned, is flowing in a loop. So like here. And one part of the loop where the current is also flowing then, for example, here at the signal return plane. So let's suppose this is the ground pin. It goes down to the ground plane. And then part of the current is flowing along over the ground plane to this, for example, capacitor. And here it comes up into the capacitor again. So current is flowing in the loop. And it's also flowing in the signal return plane. A loop is always related to an inductance, in this case, a parasitic inductance. So depending on how big is the loop area, we can define a certain inductance of this loop. Any idea how big might such an inductance be? For example, of such a printed circuit board loop area? Nanohenries. Most probably not that big, so nanohenries. Also not that big. So, but what happens if a small current change, and here we are talking about DI over DD, also amps over nanoseconds or picoseconds, is flowing across this inductance with nanohenries. There is this famous formula U is equal to L times DI over DD. The L is not that big, but the I over the D is quite big. So we are generating a voltage drop. In addition to the voltage drop that we have due to the specific resistance, we now also have a voltage drop due to the parasitic inductance, due to the rate of the current change. And how big is this voltage drop now? It's not 0-point-something volt like the ohmic resistor. It can be volts. So now I'm asking you, is this ground plane still a ground plane where we think that all over the ground plane we have 0-volt potential? Most probably not. Because with the switching frequency, the potential along the ground plane is changing. It's jumping up and down. So now here comes the problem. We have a cable here, we have a cable there. In both cables, there is a ground wire. Okay, what does this ground wire do? It's usually connected by a connector to the ground plane. Also here on this side, ground wire connected by a cable to the ground plane. We get the impression that, this is my 0-volt cable because it's the ground reference. So right ground, left ground. But in reality, when we are turning on the circuitry, we said that there is a voltage drop on the ground plane. Now I'm asking you, is the ground potential here and here really the same? No, most probably not. It's jumping up and down, or it's changing in the volts range. So now let's think. Don't think of a printed circuit board. Think of a voltage source that is connected between two cables. And the cables are pretty long. Usually they are. They are not shielded or anything. So we have a voltage source that is driving with a certain frequency a voltage drop between the two cables. And this voltage drop is generating a current. Where does the current flow? This is then our common mode current. It flows along the whole loop, however the loop looks like, out of our printed circuit board into the cable, then by stray capacitances or whatever, back, example, then over here to this cable and then back to the source. And this is in reality one of the main issues, because these common mode currents, they are usually generating quite a lot of electromagnetic emission. And it's not that easy to get rid of these common mode currents.